Alright guys, it's Sadie, and I wanted to show you, I made a negative ion generator. This is the same negative ion generator that Electronic Gold Mine has, and it's a 15 kilovolt negative ion generator. And I have it right in there, and I have a meter switch, and the fan, and then I have the output of it right here. Maybe I could take it apart so you can see. It's really simple, and then I just use like a laptop to power it. It takes 12 volts, so I just use the laptop cord that I cut up, because I have a lot of those laptop cords, laptop power. This one has an output of 5 volts at 2 amps, which I'm not using that. And then it has an output of 12 volts at 2 amps. And so I just have the 12 volt fan switch. And then I just have a current meter right there. And then you can really smell it. It really is working good. And then the main thing is the output from the high voltage transformer. You don't want it to make sparks. So I have it's kind of complicated, because you want it to be as close as possible, but if it's too close, it'll start to make sparks. And I noticed that this meter will go up a lot more because it's drawing a lot more current, but that could make ozone that way, and I don't want that. I just want the negative ions. So I have it apart enough, and to adjust it, I've been sticking this thing in through the fan and then moving that wire close the output close to the ground or farther away from the ground. But it really makes this meter go crazy. My E-field and then the Tesla meter. Oh, this, can we focus on this? Yeah. Okay, so when I turn it on, it really does generate a lot. So you obviously don't want to have it right next to you while you're sleeping, but it actually worked pretty well. It's a simple circuit, of course, but putting it in this box was nice. I put some holes there in the output is right down there. So the fan, I have the fan blowing in, and then it just is coming out there. I can go ahead and show you what's inside it, but it's pretty simple. If you know anything about electronics, you know how I wired it up. And I did have to use a resistor in between that meter and the power source. And it's just, the resistor's like, I don't know, like 2.2 ohms. And then it's one of the really thick ones, because the little 1/4 watt resistors, you know, obviously that's going to get hot, and then that's going to stay hot, and then it could burn up. And what I was doing before I found that big resistor is I was experimenting with tying a bunch of these together. And then I used this for the ground. I have the ground wire going in, like on, just soldered on there. Then I have this screwed to the bottom of this box, And then I have the high voltage wire kind of floating above it. So you can kind of adjust it, you know, by pushing it down, but I have it wrapped up in, and then I have one of those things, these things around it. But let's take a look inside here and take a look at this. So there's the negative, and I didn't want to cut this wire because this wire is, it's really thick, but it has like this little brush thing at the end. It has a little like brush thing at the end. So I didn't want to cut that. I didn't want to cut that and then just have the metal, because this helps distribute the charge. And then in the very bottom, you can see all I have is the return lead. This is obviously really easy to hook up, positive, negative, and then the green one is the ground. And then, like I said, I didn't want to cut that wire, so I just bound it up with one of these things on it, and then I can get it, I can just push it close to that, you know, close to that PCB that I just have this soldered onto, and then it's making connection with several things in there. So it's just, you know, I didn't, it's actually worked out pretty well, and it's kind of stable, you know, it's not moving around too much because it's so thick and everything kind of holds it in place. There's in there is where I have the resistor. So it just has power going in to the resistor, then I have the meter, the switch, and then they both power the fan and the negative ion generator. And then I just use the double-sided tape to put it in. So, you know, I'm pretty happy with that. It's a simple circuit, but it's nice to have some negative ions. So you can read about the benefits of negative ions, but that's it. So I got it from Electronic Gold Mine. This box I got off Amazon. This meter I got off Amazon. Amazon actually has a lot of these meters, and they're awesome. Like, I got a voltage one. I got an amp one. This is a milliamp one. I got like a 0 to 20 volt one, and I got a 450 volt one. They all come from China, and it takes a long time for them to get here. So if you order them off Amazon, it takes a while before they get here. And I'm really happy with the quality of them. They're cheap, but like, they work, you know, they work very well. See, oh, it's 150 volts. So I have a 150 volt one, 450 volt one, and then I've used some of the other ones. Like, I have in one of my shocker things, I've got this, and that's just hooked up to the capacitors just to show there's a charge on them. And then I have resistors, several mega ohm resistors to, you know, lessen that current, because if it was hooked up directly to the capacitors, it would just fry this little meter. But I picked the smallest, you know, the most sensitive meter I could find, because I didn't want to drain the capacitors that much. But I think I have it hooked up to, like, I don't know, I want to say 7 or 8 mega ohms in front of that sensitive meter. So even when I charge those capacitors, it'll stay, like, it'll charge up, and then it'll stay like that. So it's leaking, so the current's going down by leakage, but then, you know, this is drawing current, and that, it's amazing how long it'll stay up, and it slowly goes down, and you can tell because I have another one that has a meter on it, and it goes down a lot faster. So this might just have better quality capacitors in it. This is another project. But so I wanted to show you guys this negative ion generator. Maybe if we get some plants, we can put this out by the plants, and then we can have the plants making some oxygen and then have this over there. But, you know, okay, see, now it's, you see that the meter's gone way far. It's gone beyond the thing, and it's, if you can, I don't know if you can hear it. See, the wire's too close to it. If you see, so it's making sparks in there. It's too close. And that's probably making some ozone. So you want to make sure that the two wires aren't. Yeah, that's definitely too far. So all I do is just pull the wire back, pull it back. And then I can tell on the meter, because the closer it is to making sparks, it draws a lot more current, and it goes beyond the 200 on this. So I just want to keep it between the 150 and the 200, and I know it's not too close at that point. See, there we go. We're back. So, goes down so fast. But there you go. So that's all the parts. Where did I get the fans? I think I got the fans from Electronic Gold Mine. So just from Electronic Gold Mine and Amazon, you have all the parts to build this. And Electronic Gold Mine will have this on sale. And they do have, this one's 15 kilovolts, but they do have some 5 kilovolt ones. And occasionally they must have, you know, thousands of them, because occasionally they'll have them on sale. So I picked that up on sale when they do one of their, you know, 3-day sales. I didn't feel like I should put a light on this. I didn't see what the point was, but it's a nice little thing. You could hang it somewhere. I'll probably just put it on the floor. It kind of can clean the air, so somewhere where we had, maybe in the laundry room or something, I don't know. But there you go. So thanks for watching.